let's talk about Harley Quinn on DC Universe, because that's a really solid show that I know you haven't seen, but to a lot of people out there, it's way better than Birds of Prey, of which it absolutely positively is. And a lot of people are excited because it is coming back for season two in just a few days. But there's been this ongoing question about it, right? And it's not just about Harley Quinn. It really is about everything on DC Universe, and that's going to be whether or not it ends up moving over, staying on the platform, on the service, or it moves to, let's say, HBO Max. And I'm curious, you know, if you, in your dealings, have heard anything about the, I guess you could say, the popularity of DC Universe, or if there's been any kind of rumblings about it not living up to performance.
No one even talks about it. No one I know has it. Unfortunately, Titans is there and a couple other shows, but there's no, I don't know how people are watching it. Maybe they're watching it third party.
Well, I would say a lot of people are probably watching it third party.
Yes. And that's a shame, because in order to sustain the quality of show, people need to contribute to it. And yes, I don't see, you know, DC Universe going anywhere.
Honestly. Yeah, I don't see it either. And that's why this article popped up over here on what's it called? comicbook.com, where they've got they say here Harley Quinn showrunners address if DC Universe show will get a third season. And honestly, I think at this point the popularity of the show, the critical acclaim of the show is enough to push it towards more seasons. And you know, cuz DC and animation always do really well. So they tend to support that, I think, better than they support their live action movies, to be honest.
Yeah.
But this is what they say. So it says, in a matter of days, the critically acclaimed Harley Quinn will make its way back to DC Universe. And speaking with comicbook.com's J.K. Smith, Harley Quinn writer Justin Halpern revealed that while he and the writer's room have a general idea for where they'd like the show to go, they've yet to receive a season order from the higher ups at Warner Media, especially with the launch of HBO Max looming in the coming weeks. And that is problematic. That is troublesome and worrisome in my mind, because you want to get a show. If they just did the first like 12 episodes or 13 episodes, season one, and it ended in just ended a few weeks ago, and they're already getting ready for season two, that's fast, right? That's really, really fast for putting together that kind of content, which means that they probably did it for two seasons and then they're waiting to see how maybe season two holds up, I guess. But they said here that we're in a position right now where DC Universe is trying to figure out what it wants to do with the show. There's been rumblings about expanding now that Warner Media has several arms. We're exploring opportunities for other outlets, but nothing is confirmed. So what is that? I mean, come on, what does that say?
HBO Max.
Yeah. HBO Max is the other outlet, because HBO Max is going to have a much larger viewer base right off the bat than DC Universe. DC Universe, in essence, is a great idea. You know, it is. And I had it. I was one of the first adopters of it. Had it for 15 months. Barely watched it. In fact, I honestly forgot that it was there most of the time. Because, I mean, I watched a bit of I didn't watch any Titans, but I watched, like, Doom Patrol a little bit.
Great.
I need to see Swamp Thing. But I think what it was is Swamp Thing and how that show crashed and burned, all because of a paperwork error, which is the saddest thing. A lot of people just, you know, didn't really dive into it. They don't really have faith. And I know we talked about this a bit last night, where the comic book reading aspect of DC Universe is pretty cool. Being able to read on your TV is great. It works as functional. And that should be probably its own service that for the comic book fans. But if you're going to have all the DC content, and you're already going to be putting Arrowverse stuff, basically Arrowverse, over on HBO Max, it's time to just, you know, call it in and say that it's done. But my fear is that when it comes to Harley Quinn, and again, this is like, fans are going to freak out. Diehard fans of the show, and I believe there's quite a few, are going to freak out if they cancel the show and don't move it over to HBO Max because it doesn't seem to fit in with the narrative or of the content that they want to produce. And it depends on whether or not they're looking to push more family-friendly content and not really give in to a lot of the mature content. Because Harley Quinn is mature. It's very mature show. It's very funny, but it's also very superbly written. And I think if it went to HBO Max, it would find a much grander audience. I mean, is that the kind of show you would definitely check out?
Yeah, definitely. I have to disagree with you though. I don't think HBO is going to be family friendly. I think it's going to go all over the place.
I only say that because I'm talking about like streaming content, and we know that they're not bringing over anything from Cinemax, which is sucky because of Banshee, that's a great show, and Strike Back was a good show, but they're not bringing anything over from Cinemax over to HBO Max.
I foresee DC Universe will be a section on HBO Max,
kind of like on Disney Plus, where they've got the different sections.
Correct.
That would make a fair amount of sense. Now, Zeros of Heroes here does say DC Universe suffered majorly because it didn't support Xbox or PS4 apps in the first month of launch, could only watch on a computer or mobile devices. Well, I have a Roku television, and I could get it. It worked on the Roku television, so they were using it with smart TVs, but not having it be available on Xbox or PS4. Yeah, that's a big issue because a lot of people watch on Xbox or PS4. In fact, interestingly enough, the Xbox 360 was like the number one machine people were watching Netflix on a few years ago, before the Xbox One and PS4 came out and everything else. The Xbox 360 was what people were watching the most content on with Netflix. So yeah, that is something you don't want to walk away from. People look at their consoles as being a bit of a set-top box, and having access to all those apps. It's like Movies Anywhere, for example, is not on the PS4. Why isn't it on the PS4?
I have no idea. But also, Titans, which is one of their main titles, had a laughingstock of a trailer to introduce people to that show.
Yeah, that fuck Batman, you know what I mean? Line. Yeah, that fuck Batman line.
Well, the music
really
in the background, everything, man, was just awfully embarrassing.
It was, yeah. It really wasn't that great. That was one of the funnier things about it. I was always laughing at that, was just because you're like, okay. And it actually kind of turned me off from watching the show.
And it was
because
great.
I thought the trailer, and then everyone tells me the show's really good. And I think it got renewed for a season 3.
There was there's something in that show, man, where I got up and go, they can't write Superman? Are you kidding me? You're gonna agree with me. It's BS. They can't write a Superman storyline. BS. Superman. You can't write Superman nowadays. He's relevant. They made him relevant. That's all I'm going to say.
Okay. Well, and I do think they need to do something with Superman. And I think, you know, and that's, again, the issue when it comes to DC Universe is if Harley Quinn dies, and I think it's the cheapest show to make out of everything they have, you know, because they just, like, even the voice cast for the show, you've got Kaley Cuoco and Lake Bell as Harley and Poison Ivy. But Alan Tudyk voices not only Clayface, but the Joker. And it's funny that Alan Tudyk, you know, who's most known for like doing voice work in Disney animated movies, like Wreck-It Ralph and Frozen, is over there, you know, cursing up a storm and shit over on DC Universe. And then you've got Tony Hale, who did Forky in Toy Story 4, is playing, Dr. Psycho. And you know, like, he swears left and right. And it's just, it's really funny that they get all these voice actors in there that are just having fun. And you can tell the characters are having fun. And that's part of the love of the show.
Yeah.
So I can only hope at this point that that with this, I'm definitely going to be reviewing the episodes as they come out and talking about it more. Maybe doing watch parties or something.
Watch alongs. We need to do a watch party.
Yeah, doing those. To help maybe kind of get people to check it out, because I know people talk about it, but I don't see a lot of YouTube coverage on it. And that is, of course, the bigger problem here is, like, if they're going to work with these influencers or try to get the word out, they have to go to where the people are. I mean, hell, even John Campia, like, raves about Harley Quinn, thought it looked terrible, checked it out. And then he's like, oh, that's my Thursday night jam. You know, midnight hits, a new episode drop, and me and Ann go and watch it. And that's couple goals. I'll take it. So with any luck, we'll get a third season over on HBO Max, and it will finally be the death nail for DC Universe, which was a great idea in theory, but it couldn't survive corporate synergy. And that's the sad thing.
I foresee DC Universe Reborn. That's what I foresee.